Hi, my name is Morten, and in this video, we will be looking at stores in Ucommerce. Stores is the topmost level in your catalog foundation of your webshop, and this is where you define your entrance to what the users will see on your webshop based on where they come from and what domain they enter your webshop in. Ucommerce is a multi-channel solution, which means you can have multiple stores, multiple languages, multiple domains, and all of this can be configured directly within the platform itself. This means that if you have a large-scale setup where you sell to multiple countries, you have multiple users watching your webshop in multiple languages, maybe you even sell different products to different parts of the world as well. All this can be configured to be supported with multiple stores in the platform. It also means that, for example, your store managers will be able to see only their parts of the webshop, maintaining their own individual parts of the catalog system, their own catalogs, their own categories, their own products, and they will only be able to see orders placed on their webshop. All of this is possible with the multi-channel functionality. So let's try to explore that and see what we can do. Over in the navigation to the left, we have the stores node here that I can click on, and this allows me to browse all the different stores that I have in my solution. I'm currently demoing this in Umbraco, but this is the same functionality across Umbraco, Sitefinity, and Sitecore. So even though that I show you this in the CMS that you don't use, all the information that you get in this video is still relevant because it's the same across the board. So I have one store here, but what I could do is I could click up on the new button here, and then I can create my own store based on what I need. So Ucommerce stores support definitions, which allows you to assign additional metadata around your store. There's more relevant information about what a definition in Ucommerce is in another video, so you can browse that to learn more. Besides that, you can select a domain. I currently don't have any in this system, but a domain is maintained within the CMS, allowing you to specify what the users see when they enter a certain domain. That could, for example, be avenueclothing.com, avenueclothing.dk, avenueclothing.co.uk, or whatever. Based on this single field here, I can then associate a content site with a store, and thus create multiple channels for your webshop. This could be relevant if you, for example, are using brand-specific designs for certain products. If you want to only have a subset of your products relevant for a single domain, where the look and feel of this webshop should match the feeling that you get with this product. We have a lot of different customers that use this feature, and they can maintain all the different webshops and all the different content sites within the single installation here because of this single configuration point for your stores. This is also part of the content and commerce connected capabilities that Ucommerce offers, which is the ability to assign content for your webshop data, but also assign webshop data to your content pages, for example, catalogs or categories product. But in this case, we assign a domain to a certain store, and thus tying those two things together. And last thing that I need to do is to give my webshop a name. That could be avenueclothing.com. So once my my store has been created, I'm taken immediately back to the newly created store, where I can then specify the different informations that I need for my store. If you use definitions for your store, then you can have language specific data for that created with the definition. So we have a language selector up here that allows you to change the language. This also adheres to what has been configured in the CMS. We have a bunch of configuration that we can assign here. The domain, we talked a little bit about that. And then we have a currency here where you can specify what the default currency should be in case you also sell across multiple currencies of those. We have an email profile, which will be covered in another video as well, but this allows you to set up store-specific email profiles for store-specific content. So if you have multiple stores, but you want your emails that are being sent out to look and feel different, then you can have multiple profiles and thus change the configuration of that. Order numbers is also a very important part of your webshop. Every time a user places an order, he will be assigned an order number. The order number series here allows you to set up how your order number should look like when an order has been placed on this particular webshop. This allows you to track different orders from different webshops in different order numbers. Lastly, we have the ability to have your customers being created as members within the CMS when they check out. We will always know the customer once they checked out, but in some cases they want to be able to log back in and check their order history. This is possible by specifying the customer specific data down here that I want my users to be created when they check out. And if I had any member groups and member types, I could configure those here as well, allowing me to tie certain user types with my store. This is a very powerful functionality that a lot of customers are asking for, because it allows them to automatically create this page where users can go back in and review their order history. And this is actually what we have as available configurations on our store level. If we go back, we can of course see that I now have a new store here, so my overview allows me to see all of them. And for my store, I can also delete it if I wish to. I can rename it, and I can of course also change the definition. So if my store should be associated with another set of custom data, just change the definition and you'll be able to modify that. So this is what you can do with stores. If we take a very, very quick look at catalogs, we will be able to see that my catalogs overview here, I only have a single catalog. So here for my catalogs, I will be able to navigate all the catalogs based on the store that I'm currently browsing. Down here, I can change the store to avenueclothing.com, and I will have an empty catalog because I did not associate any catalogs with my store yet. So I can add a new one in here, which means that my browse functionality for my catalogs and my categories is always based on the store that I'm currently browsing. So once you have created your stores and you need to create your catalogs, changing the store down here is what you want to do. And that's all there is to say about stores for now. I hope you enjoyed the video and see you in the next one.